This is a little video tutorial on the concept of A-B testing. And A-B testing is a term that we use all the time for internet businesses, and it's a term that's well worth knowing. In marketing, there's a lot of formal marketing research that we can do, focus groups, surveys, and so on. And they're very useful, but they're expensive and they take up a lot of time. Might take you 3 months to 6 months to get the information back. It's important to do testing of our ideas, because if we don't test, we may go off in a completely wrong direction. Let me give you an example from an advertising campaign that was not well received by American audiences. We all know that really big firms sometimes make really big mistakes. In the 1990s, Nissan ran a series of commercials that, in my judgment, were not properly tested with audiences. This character, Mr. K, was supposed to represent, I don't know, the founder of Nissan, the original engineer or something, but most Americans didn't get it, and they just found the guy to be completely creepy. This commercial features Bobby and Ken getting a new car and going for a ride. Let me just show you the clip and you'll see what I'm talking about. Before we get to A-B testing itself, I want to talk about the general concept of miniature natural experiments. This is the kind of marketing research that every firm can do. And let's go through those terms one at a time: miniature, natural, and experiments. Suppose you were working for a local bagel chain here in California, and you felt that the bagels were fine, but we're just not getting enough business because the firm is under-promoted. Well, if you don't do any testing, you go off and you spend a lot of money on advertising, and then it's actually quite hard to see whether it worked or didn't work. Much better thing to do is to ask your boss for a budget and to advertise heavily in Northern California for a month, while at the same time you do not advertise in Southern California. Then the next month, you start advertising in Southern California and you stop the ads in Northern California. So miniature, first of all. Miniature, time limited, we're just going to do it for a month. A very small experiment. Natural, it is in the real world. I'm not doing a focus group asking people, would you be more likely to come in and buy a bagel if you saw a billboard? I'm actually doing the experiment in the natural environment. So miniature, natural, and then experiment. You'll note here that I start off with advertising in the north for 1 month, then I advertise in the south. This gives me data that I can compare the results of extra promotion in one market and then in another market. So that's miniature natural experiments. Now, A-B testing actually is a kind of miniature natural experiment, and you could use that phrase in a number of ways, but it's most frequently used for internet businesses. Suppose you're working for an internet business and you feel that you're getting a small number of people actually joining the site because the login button is not well located. I'm actually going to show you a couple of examples. Well, here's a website that's familiar to all of us. It's the study.net website. And I have to say myself, I find this visually confusing, and it's got this crawler along the bottom. And if I'm going to study.net and I just want to log in, wow, the login is this little button right up here, and it takes me a long time to find it. I actually don't find that very useful. Here's a comparison. This is the website for Kaiser Permanente, and they've designed it understanding that most people who are coming to Kaiser Permanente are already registered as members, and it's only a small number who need to register. And look at the size of this box here. Here's the member sign-on with the identity and the password right there. I think this is a much better laid out website. So here's how you conduct the A/B test. Instead of arguing and arguing whether the login button should be any different, we're going to do a little experiment. And it's miniature because we're not going to change the whole website yet. We're going to test it out. You call in the engineers and you say, hey, we're having a debate about whether a bigger login screen would actually get us more customers. Can you program the user interface and show us that? Then when the engineer has got programming done, which shouldn't take too long, you say, all right, we want you to conduct an A/B test. We want 5,000 people to see the old login screen and 5,000 people to see the new login screen. And because it's an experiment, the engineer is going to set it up so that that's randomized, so some people see one screen, some people see the other. Then the engineer can come back with the results. Hey, when people saw the new screen, we had a 53% conversion rate. When they saw the old screen, it was only 47%. Or perhaps the engineer comes back and says it doesn't make any difference at all. The point of an A/B test is that you can do it very quickly. Instead of just arguing over who's right, you program the A/B test and you can get the results before lunchtime. And the results are very meaningful. They're what consumers actually do on your website. So here, just a little summary. All firms, even if they're small firms, can run certain kinds of tests of their marketing ideas themselves. And we begin with the concept of miniature, natural experiments, doing something in a limited geographical environment or doing something only for a short period of time, and gathering the data, seeing whether what we're proposing has any effect at all. Then, particularly for internet businesses, we can conduct a special kind of experiment called an A/B test. And in the A/B test, we present two versions of a website and see if it makes any difference. Now, beyond the login screen, suppose you're running a clothing store on an internet business, you could test to see whether it makes any difference whether you have the welcome screen be to show a model wearing your jeans, or whether the welcome screen is something about the history of the firm. Having a picture of a model, does that make any difference? Do more people buy the jeans? So the concept of A/B testing is very important. It's used all the time for internet businesses. And the keys are that it settles disputes and that it's very quick and cheap to do. But nonetheless, it's effective marketing research because it gives us information in a very short period of time. I hope you found this explanation helpful.